I think there are a couple of key takeaways from the study. The first is that laws and policies that are designed to address bullying are effective and are working in reducing bullying behaviors among high school youth in the U.S. The second is that we found a couple different specific components of these laws that were most effective in reducing bullying. And finally, this work really sets the stage for several future studies that we'd like to conduct to further understand how these laws can be effective in continuing to reduce bullying. So for instance, we're really interested in understanding which components of these laws and which combination are most effective in reducing bullying. We're also really interested in understanding why these laws are effective. Are they effective, for example, in changing social norms around bullying within the school context? And finally, we're really interested in understanding whether these laws are effective in reducing disparities in bullying. So we know that some of our most vulnerable youth, including youth with disabilities and LGBT youth, are at disproportionate risk for being bullied. And we're really interested in understanding whether these laws might also be part of a comprehensive strategy for reducing disparities in bullying among these youth.